Dear friends, welcome back. The summer is over and I am back with a new project. Today we're going to test the new Raspberry Pi 3 board by building a simple but useful project. We're going to build a touchscreen weather station. Let's start. A few months back, the Raspberry Pi 3 board was released. It is a great new board because it now offers Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity out of the box. It uses a quad-core processor which operates at 1.2 GHz and it has 1 GB of RAM available. From the benchmarks that I have seen, this board is at least 3 times faster than the original Raspberry Pi. It can run Linux and offers 40 GPIO pins for our projects. The impressive thing is its price. It costs around $40 and Gearbest.com was kind enough to send me a sample unit in order to test it and build projects with it. You can find a link for it in the description of the video. In order to test it, I built this weather station with it. As you can see, I have connected a 5-inch touch display and a DHT22 sensor, and in the screen we can see live updates of the temperature and humidity. The temperature and the humidity values are updated every 2 seconds. If I click anywhere on the screen, the application quits so we can use the Raspberry Pi for other purposes. This project is a nice first project to build with a Raspberry Pi because you will learn how to write and run code on it, and you will learn how to use the GPIO pins of it. But let's now see how to build this project. The parts needed in order to build this project are these: a Raspberry Pi 3 or any other Raspberry Pi board, a DHT22 temperature and humidity sensor, a 5-inch touch display, some wires. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. Now let's connect all the parts together. First, we have to connect the DHT22 sensor. We connect the pin with the plus symbol to GPIO pin 40 of the Raspberry Pi. Although pin 40 is not connected to 3.3 volts, we will configure it to be high in the code later. We connect the ground pin of the sensor to GPIO pin 39. Lastly, we connect the output pin of the sensor to digital pin 38. The next step is to attach the display. It is very easy. You can also watch a detailed tutorial I have prepared about this display by clicking on the card here. That's it. Now we can power up the Raspberry Pi and load the code. Now that the Raspberry Pi is ready to use, download the code of the project from the link in the description of the video and place it in a folder named Weather Station. Along with the code, you will find a file named background.gif, which is the background image for our project. Next, we have to install a couple of libraries. First of all, we have to download the DHT22 sensor library from Adafruit. Unzip the library on the desktop, open the console and type the following 2 commands. Next, run this command in order to navigate to the library folder and then install the library with this command. That's it! The DHT library is ready to use. The next step is to install an imaging library. Type the following 2 commands and wait the installation procedure to complete. After that, we are ready to use the code. Navigate to the project folder with the following command. Then, just run the code with this command. The program will run and after a few seconds, the temperature and the humidity readings will appear. You can exit the application by clicking anywhere on the screen if you have installed the drivers for the touch display. Let's now take a quick look at the code to see how it works. The code uses the TKInter Graphical User Interface package. We have used it in the past as well and I have prepared a video on that. You can check it out by clicking on the card here. Watching that video will help you better understand what's going on here. At first, we declare all the libraries that we are going to use. Next, we define the GPIO pin 40 as an output and we set it to high in order to provide power to the DHT22 sensor. Next, we create a full screen image background by loading the image file from the weather station folder. After this, we create 2 text labels for the temperature and the humidity. With this command, we bind the click on the screen or the mouse click with the exit function, which exits the application. With this command, we call the function readSensor after 2 seconds. Note that the command is executed in a separate thread in order not to lock the user interface. The readSensor function calls itself every 2 seconds. It reads temperature and humidity from the sensor and updates the labels on the display. As you can see, with a few lines of code, we can build very impressive projects using the Raspberry Pi 3 board. The fact that the board now offers Wi-Fi connectivity out of the box makes things more interesting. We can improve this project by adding online data logging to it and weather forecast using Open Weather Map API, for example. We can also use different background images depending on the weather condition and so on. I will work more on the project soon, so stay tuned. I would love to hear your opinion about this project. How do you want to see it evolve? Please post your comments or ideas in the comment section below. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.